Hey guys, welcome back to Wind Chaser. Lost my follow me guy, so trying to play catch up. Go ahead and mark this down. Get a different angle on the planner here. Currently planting a sunflower. We started this field in field 2 last video, but obviously things kind of got a little sidetracked with the new passenger script in the Silverado. So. Went ahead and traded in the JM tender and picked up the new Meridian. Figured I would log on and plant a few acres. Get my Follow Me mod set up. the first time ever in the history of Wind Chaser that the map's actually been finished, but it's also the first time that it's ever had more than soybean and oat on the map. Now we have been playing this map since it started out as Ben's Nord in 13, and was completely gutted out of all trees and buildings and everything, so it was just the terrain and painted on fields. Been farming the same corn and soybean and barley and wheat for like 2 years, so I figured it was finally time to invest a little bit of energy to get some additional crops on the map. And with the addition of Upside Down multi-fruit mod, it makes it extremely easy because you don't have to go back and add it like all of your mods in Field Plains like you used to in 13. Now you can add crops pretty effortlessly. The only thing you might have to change is maybe a particle animation on a draper or corn header. But everything else is pretty much, you don't have to touch it even with additional crops. Because all the placeholders, all the fill planes and particle animations are in the map itself. So makes it a lot more efficient to do that. Yeah, now we now have rye, which is basically a lighter oat texture, and we have Milo, which kind of has a modified hybrid corn texture thing. Not so when we're using Milo for the grain. Then we have clover, which is the same thing as alfalfa, essentially. It's just a different crop on the farm that we can bale and such. And then sunflower. We're planting a lot of sunflower currently, so I gotta figure out a line here that we're gonna use for like, I don't know. Like 15 to alfalfa or clover next season. keep all of our mowing and merging and baling work over here. Might do field 12 as well. Just because it's so profitable for us to actually do that, and it's low effort to maintain. Don't have to plow it or plant it. It keeps regrowing back like grass. So I might just have to spray it here and there. I think we have a big enough headland. Gonna hit me. Honestly, follow me mod is retarded sometimes. gonna have to go grab the new Meridian pretty soon. So I imagine for those of you that are watching that are actual farmers, that you're probably still hauling grain, or maybe you're doing your winter maintenance. I always liked that. Back in high school, I used to do landscaping during the summers, and during the winters, when I wasn't at hockey practice or like at a game or something, I'd go over to where I used to work. And they'd always be working on something. They'd be redoing brakes on their Eager Beaver trailers, or they'd be redoing their quad axles, or, you know, stuff like that, repainting equipment, and, you know, stuff like that. Winter maintenance. Good memories. Driver's gonna go crazy. I'm actually gonna cut him off right there till I can catch up again. It's always a lot nicer when you have help. Multiplayer, but sometimes you just have to rely on Follow Me mod, which isn't the worst thing in the world, but it's definitely not the best. You can control it pretty decent, I suppose. Course play, I'm always going to be a fan of course play. Just because it's so, everything except grain cart, I think course play works well. It's just that with the grain cart, it doesn't actually recognize crops, so it doesn't recognize like grow stage or like harvestable versus harvested. So if I have course play as grain cart because I want to run combine, it doesn't. And if you're not paying attention, it kind of like really screws it up. But you can start and stop your cart driver. But you have to be pretty active in what you're doing with the grain cart driver. Otherwise, he'll just go drive right through the middle of your crop. So you have to be pretty on top of it if you're running combine with AI on grain cart. But works great for tillage. Works great for spraying. Works great for trucks for hauling grain. I haven't used course play in such a long time now that I've had the server and I'm doing multiplayer. But so I don't know what kind of changes have taken place. over the last probably 6-7 months since I last used it, but I would say that's probably like one of the best mods. Collaboration of individuals in FarmSim is truly amazing what they were able to accomplish. Then again, MRN13 was amazing. Amazing as well. Soil management in 13 and now 15 is also, it's what keeps me playing the game really. Reaching the tipping point here. That's where this guy is coming, that is gonna take this line. I take this line. And now our lanes get a little bit shorter again each pass. Planting is so much quicker than tillage. Easily get all of our planting done in 2 days with these planters. At 9 miles an hour, we're doing some high speed planting. I'm really excited to get to harvest the sunflower. It looks nice when it's growing, but the harvest state is just, it looks like pure death. I was gonna do Milo, but I didn't update the multi-fruit map before I started planting, so I just scratched the Milo. We'll probably do some Milo and some rye or oat. This next season, as we pick up the acres, we're gonna be picking up a lot more acres, and we don't really have money for extra grain facilities, so I'd rather take some lower yielding crop. Such as a sunflower, canola, maybe Milo. I'm not really sure what the Milo is, and I'll have to double check on that, but I don't think Milo is that high of a yielding grain either, but I'd have to check. Eventually, you guys are going to be seeing the DB120 make it back into the game. As we start picking up more and more acreage, and we're gonna need to cover the ground quicker. The issue is we can plant the acreage, but it's, we're still limited with how much we can plow, chisel plow and stuff like that. So. I'd probably be doing a lot more fall application of nutrients and using the 26-23 50-foot disc instead of chisel plow, and then we'll probably just limit our chisel plowing to newly acquired fields just to bump up those nutrients, and then hopefully eventually they incorporate some kind of a soil compaction layer with soil management, so we'll actually have to go back and utilize our chisel plow or do some 2100 vertical ripping in some fields and stuff like that. So that would be ideal. Kind of forces us to use our chisel plow. More than the disc. I mean, you get more value for your money and nutrients if you plow it in, but sometimes it's easier to just disc it in with like a cultivator and then come back with our Patriot sprayers and spray, or use our land roller to put in the moisture, depending on what our moisture levels are. In the forecast, we have some pretty decent rains coming in. We have probably in the next 10 days, we have nothing really warm over 22, and we have a couple good rains in there, a couple hours of rain. So that's going to help us add back that moisture we lose during we lose from plowing and all that dried fertilizer we put down. Because when we started plowing, a lot of our fields were around 80% moisture. Now they're not really close to that. Now we're at 14% moisture. So it's been about 7 days since we finished chisel plowing, I believe, or something like that. I don't remember. It took us like 2.5 days to harvest. Then we went to a new week. It took us like 2 days to apply nutrients, 2.5 days to plow and stuff. So that was like a full week worth of nutrient application and plowing. But we did a lot of chisel plowing and not a whole lot of disking. So we usually would be able to cover a lot more acres. 658 acres an hour with the 2623 and the MT875. So we could cover a decent amount of ground with just one of those digs. So figure 120 acres an hour with two of them. So basically tillage would take us, if we were to do that rate the whole time, it would take us 10 hours, a little over 10 hours to cultivate all of our fields. So we can definitely cover the ground. We can farm this whole map easy. It's about 2,600 farmable acres, tillable acres, I should say. So, and we can do all of that. You know, that's essentially 24, 26 hours worth of tillage. So we'd be able to do our nutrient application and get it all disked and incorporated in no problem in a 5 day. And worst things worse, I'll just maybe extend the grow stage from 5 days to 7 days, a full week. And then I think what I'll do is I'll extend the lease time to reflect that new growth weight, because right now it's 20 days and my seasons are, what are my grow stages, like 5 days times 5, 6 grow stages, so, you know, the lease is 20 days and my grow season is 30, so I'm going to have to go back and change that, because I don't want to renew my lease before, you know, 2/3 away during the season. Doesn't cost anything more, it's just annoying because you always have to update and it's hard to calculate. As we're about ready to wrap up this field 44. Getting close to being finished with their seed as well. So what I'll do is I'll fold this one up. contender. Fully loaded a seed. Guy's done. Fold him up. Guy's at 95.5 hours. This the corn. Go ahead, unfold it, lower it down, back it under the auger there. Automatically fills as we back, which is nice. quite a bit of seed. Got nice fully loaded planters now. Got a GPS line. Got a big field of corn that needs to be planted. Probably gonna be boring to watch, but still gotta record. Missed a little bit on our tillage here. Looks like it's going to be a little overcast, a little cloudy today. It's a little bit gloomy, which personally I like that kind of weather when it's kind of rainy out, kind of gloomy, kind of cloudy. I prefer that over like super hot, sunny, no cloud, overcast days. I'll take a cloudy, overcast day any day of the week. Plus that's a lot better for fishing anyways if you're into bass fishing or walleye. Really good fishing weather. When you have just no overcast, no cloud cover, and it's warm out, it's just terrible fishing. So be interesting to see how far we can go with these planters on this field, seeding in corn. Definitely uses like a fraction of what sunflower does. It's probably like half of soybean usage and soybeans half of sunflower usage, so. Hopefully we can do most of this field without refilling. That'd be really great, actually. We have these tanks with the refuge tanks are actually spec'd at 340 bushel. I think that might be a little bit high because I think these big tanks are actually 100 bushel a piece and that refuge might be a little bit less. I'm not sure. I don't actually remember, so. I think even 12,000 liters on this rig is a little bit too much, but what can you do? Not a very realistic turn, but again, what can you do? I didn't think I was gonna plant this much tonight, but what can you do when you're not tired? You're not tired, so what better way to get tired than an hour or two of planting? Finally found some nice videos of the Mantico land rollers, so I'm probably gonna work on that maybe like next week or next weekend or something like that. kind of ran out of time for this week and weekend to get stuff done, so glad that I finished up that tender when I did. I didn't have any patients yesterday or today, so but tomorrow's Saturday. It's kind of like my had my weekend. Thursday to Friday instead of Saturday. Sunday is obviously Valentine's Day, so my weekend's pretty much shot already before it even gets here. They have some weeds growing. Interesting. I haven't updated to the new soil mod yet that Decker released on FSUK. I see he made some other changes on his GitHub account. So that's probably something I'll need to go ahead and update. Update some HUDs, I suppose. Update some animations on our corn headers and on our draper. Well, rye is basically oaked, so I don't have to do anything with that. The milo and the sunflower I need to add for sure. And I think the big made in Germany has some of that stuff already. Mods that come with the map that already have those kind of animations in there, so probably go back and look at that. I downloaded that a while ago because it's a well done map that I like to use as a reference anytime when I'm trying to do things. So I made it a little bit more hilly up here in the middle. It was just too big of a bowl shape for me, so I didn't really like it. It kind of bothered me. So I added a little bit more elevation over there on the east side of 26, west side of 27. Giants is going to turn their attention to American farming. You know, make some large American corn planters, air seeders. They have license with Horsch, so I imagine going with Horsch Anderson air seeders, you know, the big 64 foots or the 24 row high speed planters. I imagine that'd be fairly easy for them to do. because, I mean, the standard in-game trench is like, you know, the New Holland and Case, they're easily, you can change those pretty easy into an American version and not get rid of the European version like I have on these T9s. Same with the combines and all that stuff, but the implements are still small, and you pretty much have to model up like I have any kind of big implement, any kind of big corn planter, any kind of big cultivator, or disc, or seed tender, or grain trailer. But it'd be nice if they kind of directed their attention to kind of get more. For example, like an American spreader, like a Rogator, that would be great if part of this Challenger thing that they're getting into is if they were part of like Rogator with changeable dry box and liquid. I think that would be really impressive if they were to do that. I think 3 passes for headlands is more than enough. Usually I like to do 4, but 3 is good enough for turning. As long as it's more than 2, I don't really have to worry about planters overlapping into another field or really getting stuck on power lines or stuff like that. As long as I'm careful about what I'm doing, I'm close to those kind of objects. I think some of the guys are just playing like own single player games right now, testing out new mods, like new 775 and doing some of their own planning and stuff like that. Server work gets kind of boring, and we're pretty much doing the same thing over and over, where go play on your own, you can do your own dairy operation or whatever, kind of like my own. I haven't been on my save game for beef in a while. But I made so many changes to the fruit GRE file and stuff like that. It's kind of out of date, really out of date. But I didn't have much crops planted anyways. Times like this when I wish I was running 2 48 row planters. But the row units stayed on, so the tire might have lifted off the ground, but the row units were maintaining ground contact. It works! Apparently this whole bar is designed to flex 15 degrees, and either direction, up or down. So. Same with the DB120. Here, and I'll probably call it a day. Pick up some other time. See how big field two is that we're doing. It's gonna take quite some time to get this one planted. We have I'd say 500 acres left to plant, maybe more. But we're making progress, and that's all that matters. Giant mound here. I don't know how that happened. It's definitely a giant mound right here. But yeah, that new Meridian works really, really slick. You just it automatically unloads or overloads, I guess, is the term Giants wants to use. You just move the trigger right over the planter and voila, starts filling up. I like that. It's ease of use. Let's see how far we can pan out here. It's been a while since we planted this field of corn. Got some really big corn fields this year. Whether we'll be able to sell all of it in an hour with two trucks going, not quite sure. angled directly over the planter. Up about 30% of our seed. Anyways, probably call it a day. We're probably right about the hour point, so thanks for watching.